Halleluja, Halleluja, Halleluja. Tell us, Mary, what did you see on the way? I saw the glory of the risen Christ. I saw his empty tomb. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. On the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb and we don't know where they put him." Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping. And as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in white sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" She thought it was the gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I'm going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he told her. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, I apologize for not changing the lecture. But I thought Sister Mary Rose would have seen it because it's her feast day. Well, not her feast day, but one of her favorite saints. There was a beautiful homily this morning in the Office of Readings by Pope St. Gregory the Great. And what I really liked about his homily on St. Mary Magdalene is what he said about her, which we heard proclaimed in the Gospel. He said that she remained at the tomb, and she was still seeking the one that she had not found. And while she sought, she wept. And burning with the fire of love, she longed for him. I thought to myself, that's what each of us needs to be about. We need to remain. You know, what happens when we become afraid, when something doesn't go the way that we want, we want to scurry about doing all these things, and it doesn't change anything. If we would only be still and remain. And then at the same time, continue to seek, to wait, and to weep, because the weeping is a sign of our absolute longing. As the psalmist said this morning, my body pines for you, and what we heard in the responsorial psalm. See, longing increases the desire of our hearts. And although I can't say for certain, because I don't know why Jesus chose to reveal himself to Mary Magdalene first, maybe, just maybe, it has something to do with what Gregory the Great said about her remaining and continuing to seek and to weep as she sought the Lord. This reveals a deep, deep desire for relationship. And that is exactly what Jesus is looking for. He has already demonstrated his deep, deep desire to be in relationship with each of us. God is dying for a relationship with us. And in turn, we must demonstrate our deep, deep desire to be in relationship with him.